Hey guys, just give me a few seconds to get things set up over here and just waiting for it to show up so I can get a chat on my iPad. And we're off. So I've kind of been feeling nostalgic recently and I need to turn the sound off on that. and I've had the urge to play an old game from my childhood, which I'm hoping that people will find entertaining to watch because I've decided to stream it, so streaming it. The game is, big reveal, Bugs Bunny Lost in Time. I absolutely love this game. This is from the PlayStation 1 era, as you can tell by the incredible graphics, like absolutely amazing, obviously. Sort of things like that. But yeah, it's a collectathon-adventure thing, and I'm just gonna not go to. Had to load up its demo there because I was waiting on the menu too long. And here we go. Actually, starting the game. Come on, game. I know you. There we go. So yeah, it's an adventure collect-a-thon thing with Bugs Bunny as the main character, obviously. It has an incredibly awesome sense of humour, as do most Looney Tunes things. So I'm gonna go quiet while the cutscenes are on.
Here I am, Pismo Beach. Hey, wait a minute. This doesn't look like Pismo Beach. I probably should have turned right at Albuquerque and. Ooh, look at the size of this carrot juice dispenser. Yipes!
And that is the plot of the game, effectively. I don't know, there's something just about the old Looney Tunes cartoons and Looney Tunes sense of humor that I absolutely love. And God, that thing is loud. Give me a quick second just to. Hopefully that's good. That's better for you guys as well. It looks like the audio levels are okay on the software.
Come right in. How do you do? My name is Merlin, and I'm a sorcerer.
Yeah? Really? A sorcerer? Come on, let me see a saucer. Huh? Please, please?
Of course. Anything to oblige a guest.
You know, that's a good trick, Moyle, old Goyle. Can you do this one? That gave him a hobby, but I still ain't nearer to my natural habitat. Sorry to interrupt this entertaining demonstration, but can you tell me where I am?
It seems that you are lost in time, my dear. Here, it's nowhere.
Nowhere? And do you know how I could get back to somewhere?
Of course I know. You must go from one era to another and find symbols like this. They will open you new locations and will progressively lead you back to present time. All right, listen carefully, Rabbit. Get 10 of these objects to receive a clock symbol. That's it for now. Bye.
Yeah, goodbye, Moyle.
So as Merlin with his incredibly trustworthy voice there described, we are basically going to be going through the game hunting for clocks and golden carrots. You can see there we had like various counters on our start screen for it. Each level has so many golden carrots, so many clocks. Clocks being more valuable than golden carrots. I think is golden carrots to buy clocks effectively? This is the tutorial area, so it's going to start off a bit slow here, folks, but I haven't played this game in probably over a decade, so I could kind of use the refresher myself. And I was not watching that. I think I've got to jump on the chain. And God, the controls. PS1 era controls. The analog sticks don't even work. And the PS1 had on analog sticks, but it's just this game, for some reason, doesn't seem to work with them. Whoop. There we go. I was trying to spin around it, but that's not actually something you need to do in this game. Thinking more modern stuff, I guess. Like, that's not even a modern thing. That's something like old Zelda games had, isn't it? Where you had to scoot around the chain in order to jump off a specific side.
Action. It can be used as an attack against enemies.
Okay. Let's go attack Merlin's little apprentice. And... Oh! And we killed him. I'm so sorry, sir. Never mind. He just disappeared and appeared again. Either that or Merlin has a surplus of apprentices and he's just trying to shorten the supply. Extra jump on his head. Come on. Over here. Come on, let me marry you. Yeah. God, the controls. Damn it. I'm not used to all games. Damn it. Get back it. Okay, I literally just jumped off his head there. Like, everybody saw that, right? There we go. Got him. That was far harder than it should have been. Like, ridiculously so.
It could work. You could also try to tire him out first. When he stops, kick his behind, bunny.
So, sorry if you can hear that. That's me moving around in my chair. And boom! Right up the arse. And a golden carrot for my troubles. Wait, there was a carrot up his arse? Or, wait, kicking him loose? I'm not even going to go down this frame of mind. This one is just pushing boxes. I don't need to see all the signposts. It pretty much just tells you what to do when you get close to them anyhow. I believe I need to put one. And this is it. As I said, I've not played this game in over a decade, but... And I know this is a very simple puzzle, but still, it's... Like, it just comes back to me in certain... So I don't even need the first box, and maybe it's not... I remember doing this tutorial so many times as a kid. I'll need this... Damn it, game! There we go. Oh, yeah, it's going to take some getting used to playing an old game again. Like, there's a lot of old classics out there that had amazingly fun stories and gameplay and were just very well wrote. However, it's... I need to activate the sign to get the golden character up here. I do need to talk to all signs. But yeah, the controls, there's a lot of things that have advanced a long way since they originally were originally released. This is a new chair, but I didn't expect it to be this creaky. What's it? I think it's because I'm right up next to my desk. Yeah, it's rubbing against the desk. Ew. Being an idiot. And ow. All that. And there we go. Don't know why, but you have to do that little hop, or that dive, not hop, to gain the expert height there. Come on, Merlin. What do we want here? Yeah. I try not to skip dialogue and stuff in games, but when it comes to a tutorial, it's not really a big loss. Damn it! There we go. Ankle. Next off, we'll go here, I guess. It's like trampolines, I'm guessing.
Bounce on some enemies to reach inaccessible objects or grounds.
Hmm. So two golden carrots here. One above the enemy, one above this. There we go. Now, I actually do remember for its time, there was a lot of really fun mechanics in this game. Like a lot of movement-based ones. Like he just saw me kind of show off one of them there. And actually we'll do this one, which is going to talk about that one. Easier
to land on explosive objects like TNT boxes without injuries. Use the here's action to softly land on it.
So yeah, there is propeller ears. Like, obviously, why wouldn't you have that if you're a bunny rabbit? And terrible movement controls. This is gonna, I'm gonna die so many times while playing this. So, for some reason, it didn't activate the, despite me pressing the button. Now I remember why old games are old games, damn it. Okay, might literally throttle you, bugs, if you're not careful. Damn it! I swear, this stream will, at some point, get out of the tutorial. Specifically, it'll get out of this single area. Okay, I'm going to be very careful here. And we're good. Next is this one. I think this is just how to throw.
You can pick up objects and throw them to enemies. You can also pick them up, move them, and drop them somewhere else.
Something looks a little off about that shadow there. I want to pick up and square to throw. Boop! We are really abusing Merlin's apprentices here. Like, how are they? How are they still his apprentice? Like, I think they must be really desperate to learn magic if they're willing to put up with all this shit. It can also be used on fragile grounds. I do not believe you. Except he is telling the truth. I just really can't believe him in that voice. Like, just out of spite. So, gotta sneak over the bridge in order to make it not break. And over to... is there not a golden carrot here? Huh. We're supposed to kick him while he's... Right. Yep, there we go. I was going to say, I could have sworn there was a golden carrot for that challenge, as I believe they're off for all of them. And my favourite movement mechanic. It's so simple, but yet just adds so much to the game, I thought. I say thought because, you know, opinions back when I was a kid aren't necessarily the same as the opinions I've got now. I actually don't know what my opinions are now because I've not played it in over a decade, as I said before. But it is a cool little thing. Like, you can't pop out of it unless it's a hole. So like, I couldn't jump out here. Weirdly, the rabbit can't make a rabbit hole. So you basically got to look for holes like that. That's the only way you can get in and out of the ground. Speedrunner, and then he gets caught behind a sign, just to prove me wrong. I believe now if I go in, I think that was the 10th golden carrot. Should be able to get out of the soil. Can I do it?
Start your quest. It opens the Stone Age era. Get in and there, choose one of the opened entrances. Visit all of them and get back all the hidden clocks they contain.
Great! Thanks, Smile. Anything else?
Yes. Of course, picking up carrots will raise up your energy. That's it for now. We'll probably meet again somewhere in time. Time traveling is one of my favorite hobbies. I'll teach more later, time traveler. Goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye, Mile. Collecting symbols. Well, why not? After all, they laughed at the man when he discovered the penicillin.
Did they? I probably shouldn't be just assuming things from the Toons are factual, so I'm not going to even comment. Alright, so we've actually unlocked our first world. And this is where, you know, we actually start to play the game as opposed to running around the little obstacle course that... He called him Moyle, but I'm pretty sure that Bugs is just being a bit of a dick and getting his name wrong. I'm pretty sure it's Merlin. But I might be wrong. I'm already not paying enough attention. So this is the hub world for Prehistoric. Right now, we have Wabbit on the run. That nose is so itchy. Alright.
Today's hunt is Wabbit.
Yeah, Wabbit, yeah.
Hey! What's up, dog? Wabbit!
Yeah, Wabbit,
And bonk. Alright, so this is the first level of the Prehistoric Age. And as you see, there's like a little hub world for each age. And each one has various levels, mini-games, and bosses. So, I guess we'll go this way first. And there's a shadow there. I remember playing games like this. Controls. I used to love games like this when I was a kid. I never really had collectathons as a thing, but I guess like when I think of collectathons nowadays, for some reason, I'll get under there. Damn it. For some reason I think of things like Banjo-Kazooie, I'm suddenly running out of ideas. Banjo-Kazooie, Spyro, I don't know why, but when I started this frame of mind, I was thinking Nintendo games. But literally, now I think about it, there's a lot of really cool PlayStation era collectathons, which a few of which I had, and I always really enjoyed them because I've got, you know, I'm OCD and I love collecting like literally everything in games. I get under there. Oh, a roll, of course. Boop. First clock. Yeah, beyond the tutorial one. And need to be up here anymore. I can't remember where. Ow. I hate that noise. I remember that noise. I remember that noise as soon as it happened. And so yeah. Boop. Oh, I need to get behind you. And then aim. You know what? Let's just jump on your head. That's easier. Bye bye. And I get a golden carrot for every enemy defeated. They sound like you're gonna get a lot of golden carrots, but there's really not that many enemies on levels. You know, I had a train of thought before I saw that enemy, and it's literally gone from mind. This is the, I don't know, I don't want to say sleep deprived, because I'm really not. This is my idiotic state, and I'm getting a bit of lag there. Oop, hopefully that's not going to be a constant. But yeah, I do remember bits and pieces about this game. It's been a long time, but the amount of times I've played it, I don't think I ever completed it. I rarely completed games as a kid. Like, if ever, now I come to think about it. I'm trying to think what the first game I ever actually completed was. I want to say Halo, but that's really late into my life. Like, I must have completed games before then. Like, I never completed the Final Fantasies. I got to the last dungeons in a couple of them. I never actually completed them because I was impatient as a kid, and by that time I'd kind of got on board of them, although nowadays I absolutely love them and have gone back and completed a few of them since then. In fact, plug, completing Final Fantasy VI now on my channel with Bezekla. Yes, that's right, I have to sort his name whether he's here or not. I'm trying to think, I completed games like Super Mario World, Sonic, like full on games that you could complete in a single session. Beat them, fine. But as soon as it got to, even like Sonic 3, as soon as you got to the point where you're making save files and therefore were less likely to complete in a single sitting, although don't get me wrong, I'm not saying you couldn't complete Sonic 3 in a single sitting, but that's where I started to not complete games. Like, I don't think I ever completed, I ever completed Sonic 3. Like, I'm not going to want to, like, so I am thinking I'm going to try and stream old games like from my childhood and stuff I'd never played as a kid more often, because I do absolutely love retro games. Like I said before, there's issues with the controls and the just general advancements, damn it, that have come with modern game design and such, but there's still just a certain charm. And just I glitched through the bridge there. That totally not my fault. Yeah, there's a certain charm and nostalgia for games like this. Like, even games I've not played, like a while back, myself and Scarbius were playing through various we're playing through various old games or Retro Redux, another series of ours. And like he would even games that I'd never played that he recommended, Gunstar Heroes and Streets of Rage, still just nostalgic. Like, even without playing them, I don't get it. I guess it's the kind of style of them would make sense. Like, the games themselves aren't just, you know, not just the writing, the specific characters that you're nostalgic for, although in some cases it very much can be. It's the actual, just the general game design of back then, because it has changed. Like, even the stuff that, you know, you wouldn't think would really have that many, I see you. Even the stuff you wouldn't think would have that many advancements. Like, and I may be sounding incredibly ignorant here, but for example, things like writing, you wouldn't think that that's the kind of thing that would, I don't know, I don't feel like that's the kind of thing that will improve over time. But it kind of, like, it has, I feel like, I mean, not when you look at, like, full, obviously Shakespearean pieces of art, like the Call of Duties, ow. It's just another carrot, ow, okay, I messed up, no, I didn't. Okay, I think I need to bounce off Elmer's head to get a pair, don't I? Elmer, come over here. Thank you. Okay, come over here more. Thank you. 9 o'clock. So, as I don't know. I'm sure there are writers out there that have studied like how to write, and there are obviously there's going to be new methods, new theories and stuff as to what makes the best script, what makes the best stories, stuff like that. But it doesn't feel like it's like it feels like, for example, Shakespeare should be as good as writing as any writer from our days nowadays, right? But then there's things like programming, graphics, stuff like that have hugely improved. And these things have just changed games so drastically. Okay, I made it. And come on, bend down. Oh. Not you, I didn't want to. So basically just waiting for the time loop here. There we go. Okay, I thought I was going to run off there. And another clock and 2 golden carrots. So is that 5 out of 9 now already? The controls. But yeah, there's just so many games from my childhood that very much it could be explained by nostalgia, but these games like decade and a half old now, that I would still very much consider within some of the best like old times games. I know there's lots of people out there that would agree with me, but I'm always curious to see if these things are fully nostalgia, or if, for example, you took a guy, a kid who, like 13, 14 years old, and wasn't even alive when some of these games were made, and see if they, like, after playing on hits and that, so they've got the point of reference and that, be curious to see what the actual effect is and stuff. I'm sure the study's been done about this, and I could probably look it up, but I'm extremely lazy. I have a feeling that something's around here. Say something that I'm down to? No. I think what I'm thinking of is that golden carrot there. Let's say there's just. Found you, cactus. I see you. Cunningly disguised in the desert? It's like a canyon, I guess, isn't it? What? It's not full on desert, but it's like. That carrot was still jumping. What form does it? It's not like it. I get there. Yeah, it's just a prehistoric canyon, I guess. I don't know why I'm really spending that much time thinking about it. It's. I guess I need to do something while okay, we're down here now. Okay. I get it. Just drop me off wherever you want. Thank you. Guess we need to take advantage of the sneak mechanic here. And that anvil went back into the sky somehow. Like, that doesn't seem physically possible. Okay, so there's a golden carrot there. Better get it from the other side. Let's walk around Mr. Pterodactyl there. Grab the clock. Thank you. See, I remember having so much trouble, even on this first level when I was a kid. And don't get me wrong, I'm still messing up a lot of the movement here, but it's just, I feel so different now. And in a good way, I'm not going to lie. Feels good to go back to it though. Great. And that should be a game I'd be interested to see a speedrun. I'm a big fan of the GDQ events, and I don't think I've seen this played in that yet. It probably has been, actually. I've just probably not seen the archive footage or anything of it. Yeah, be interested with all the kind of sneak stuff that as a kid I thought you had to do. Interesting to see what they're. Damn cactus, you finally got me. It'd be interesting to see what speedrun could actually do to it. I'm sure there's many glitches. 21 out of 2. I get them by going. I feel like I've fully explored the area. Nope. I'll bounce off you. You'd never see it coming. Oh no! Stop that. Let me see what you're doing, Mr. Pterodactyl person. Okay. Thank you. Just gonna go over here, just minding my own business. Come on. Good, yep. Bird boy. Yes, that's right. And... no, doesn't look like we got a clock or anything. Pardon me.
Good, but you left some stuff behind you.
Oh, that's another soundbite that I cannot stand. Pretty sure it says that every time you leave a level and you've not got...
save your position.
Oh, man, it's all coming back to me. His voice. His horrific voice. Alright. No clue where I left them. I'm trying to think. I'm pretty sure I explored everywhere I can explore. Oh well. I might go back to it later. For now, let's just... let's carry on. Guess who needs a kickstart? Image, I would assume it means Elmer. It's just a very special kind of humour for Looney Tunes. Oh, I think I'm trying to think where the golden carrots may be, but I think... okay, actually, see what I need to do here as well. Ow! Nope, not that. Don't need to do that. God damn it! Yeah, you keep laughing. Nope. Okay, button's not working now. Damn it! Okay, I got it. And boom! And yeah, get a golden carrot for each time you hit him. Where are you? Oh, you're there. Oh, and you actually get two golden carrots for every time you hit him. That's interesting. And... boop! I remember this boss fight. Did this a few times. That's the thing about old games. I remember so much about the beginnings of them, but not so much about the ends, because I used to restart games so often. Still do, in fact. I've got a really bad habit. So I've chatted to Scarbys about it earlier. It's where if I leave a game for too long, I just can't go back to it. Like, even a month or so, I struggle to go back to it without restarting. Really bad frame of mind, because it means that this is the reason I never really completed that many games as a kid. Ugh. And my aim leaves a little bit to be desired. But we made it. Next level. On me. Hit my headset there as well.
Great. Boop-boop. Just perfect. You have completed this level. Let me save your position.
Hopefully my voice isn't being too choppy here. I am using some new settings on my microphone stuff to try and cut out background noise. I'm trying to keep an eye on it and it seems to be okay so far, but we'll find out later. If not, you guys may have already found out. If not, I'm keeping an eye on it, so hopefully that's a sign that it's doing all right. Okay, finished with the Stone Age for now, and the pirate years. As we saw, there was another bunny hole that opened up. It was that's 100 clocks, Christ. God, like I'll admit. When I restarted this, I'd thought that it was, like, you'd do all prehistoric levels, all pirate levels, all so-and-so levels. But God, how all over the place it is. And it's good for that, because it means you've varied throughout, like, you're not just doing big, like, half an hour of dinosaurs, half an hour of pirates, half an hour of whatever. You kind of split it up over bits. Very good at making friends is Bugs. Greatest of friends, people. I don't know what I'm saying there. I really don't know what I was doing there.
Get five of these objects to
just get
Bug
Nose quickly.
Symbol.
You done? Yeah, game. There we go. Sorry, I'm still suffering from the eternal cold I seem to have had all winter. Aha! That's a carrot. That's also a carrot. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm not just kicking this randomly. I'm pretty sure... Okay, yeah. It basically has a set amount of stuff that it drops. I'm not sure if that can be gotten carrots or not. So, I'm going to be... Oh, yep. Yeah. For example. There we go. And that's a lot of drops. So, that doesn't seem physically possible. You're a crab. Not Captain Boomerang. Damn it! There we go. And... Boop! And bonk. So yeah, actually, no, you don't get a golden carrot for every enemy defeated. As I said previously, I have... It's not the first... Boom? Okay. One. Okay, I guess you get something for beating all the Acme boxes. All the Acme bosses. Those boxes are the true boss. And it looks like we're coming up on a little minigame. Ah, oh, bloody nose! What? Okay, I guess we've got to touch the chest first. Okay. Doop, doop, doop. Okay, left. It was... Which direction was it facing from? Okay, it was that way. That's good. I wasn't watching where the carrot was. Oh, like, dust mote or something. I think it was... Okay. It's just not... I can't tell it goes so quickly. I can't tell if it's a golden carrot or a normal carrot. Eh. Okay. There we go. It's just a normal carrot. Didn't need to do that at all. Waste of time. 1 out of 10. Okay, and you just need to kick the wheel to lower the drawbridge. Gotcha. Figured it out. I am in fact a genius and the best gamer ever of all time. I don't know how you could dispute that. He says, kicking the... Damn it! Die. Oh, that always happens. Whenever I'm talking about how much I'm the greatest gamer ever, there's always something like that happens. Just to prove me wrong. Because karma is in fact a bitch. I'll just be able to place this here and get it, can I? Yes, I can! Wet bunny. Do dee dee dev doop boop boop. Speaking of advancements and stuff, like, there's so many advancements and stuff with music and that in games, but this soundtrack is just so perfect for the game. Like, it is Looney Tunes to a T. Okay, let's get a bit higher. You back. I got it. I can do this. Oh, watch the back. Yep. Okay, can't tell if I'm lifting something or constipated there. Okay. Let's try... Gotta walk with the bloody ones. Get on top of here. Looks like we can jump just as high. Oh no, it's... Okay, there we go. Okay, I have no clue if we need to be up here, but there's something that I can't just normally jump onto there, and I need to jump onto it just to make sure there's nothing that triggers when you go up there. Nope, especially since it looks unique, damn it, like a treasure chest design. So how do I get up there? Can I push? These look different. Yeah, there we go. I'm a genius. Greatest game ever, 10 out of 10. Literally the best. Of all time. Got it. Damn it. So I'm curious what other games there are from other people's childhoods that they love. Like, it's one of the fun things about doing Retro Redux with Laurie, if anybody ever saw that. is the fact that it gave me a idea of what another person of, I was going to say another person my age, but just in general, another person like remembers of their childhood, like gaming wise. I need to separate these bloody boxes. Like, the problem is. Oh, no. No? There's a way to split them. There we go. And one of them's in the water, of course. And the. Literally couldn't have thrown in a worse direction. Guys! No! Okay, I've got one hit before I'm dead. And I'm dead. Oi! Greatest gamer ever. Literally of all time, ever. Oop, carrot. Could use that a minute ago. Almost just walked off for the sake of it there. Alright, no kidding around this time. We got it. We've figured it out. We know what we're doing. Can totally master these not all awkward PS1 era controls. See, made it all the way over here without any error. Still gotta beat the crabs before I can get that box. Damn it! Go in the direction I'm telling you to, bugs! You won't be taking as much damage if you do that. Okay. Let's kick him in this direction so we can get his carrots, or they can go that way. Works. Okay, we got it. Pardon me. Okay. Finally get up here, see what's actually up here. It only took us God knows how long. Damn it, bugs, get up here. There we go. Camera. Truest enemy, all games. That's that one. Just need to get the other crate onto the. Well, basically one step past that one. And we've got it. Ah. Okay, so actually, I don't need to press the jump button. I can just walk to the edge and it makes. Ah. Ah. Ooh. Right. No, bugs. Bugs. Okay, made it. Now, watch there be absolutely nothing in this chest. Never mind, that's a clock. We'll take it. We have got it. Okay. Down here now, I guess, where we killed the crabs. Oh. Probably go see a doctor about that. Oh, no, I guess that's the opposite of. I know why that happened. That's because I took far too long. Oop. Okay. Get bugs, pick it up. Damn it, bugs! Wait. It's not because I'm picking the pearl, I'm pretty sure. It's because of. Yeah, it's because I was taking too long. And. Boop! Greatest carnival game. And you gotta do it times, of course you do. Thank you, bugs. Gotcha. For the first person there to make sure I get my aim right, you know, pro plays. That's not the pickup button. Literally, every time I talk about how well I'm doing at the game, or, you know, try and make some jokey comment about me being awesome, game just has to prove me wrong. I say game as if it's not my own crappy, playing! Ow. Hoi! Yay. Alright. Eh! Donkey Kong in this bitch. And yeah, torch. There. Oh! Camera! Need camera! Oh! One hit away from death there. That's the last checkpoint is actually right at the start, isn't it? Damn it, camera! Gotta be probably a button that kicks it right behind you, but not sure where it is. Hitbox on those things is really annoying. And there was a crate glitching for a crateception. Great crate inception. Great crateception. English hard. especially when you're making up the words as you go and being terrible at video games at the same time. Just, you know, can't be terrible at two things at once. Well, actually, apparently I can. Apparently I can't be mediocre at two things at once. I can only be terrible at two things at once. Better not try doing three things or more at once. Who knows what would go wrong. Probably somebody would die. Horrible, horrible death. The explosions, there'd be... Pretty sure Godzilla would be there. Like, just feel like that would be a thing. Pretty sure he would somehow turn up. I'd be wrong, but I just see it happening. So, that's it. Never going to try doing more than two things at once. Technically, I am breathing right now as well. So, there's probably literally going to be death all around, as I'm playing games, speaking, and breathing at the same time. Some of you may say, yes, I was doing that previous anyhow, so doesn't that kind of make previous point somewhat mute? And I say you're probably correct. I'm not sure where this joke is going. And explosions. Woohoo! Yeah. Animation so much. This run, right from the start, one does not seem to be walking to model, is... I feel like we've just done it a few times. Just, I feel like I've seen these chests a few times before. Come on, Bugs. You can do it. I believe in you. I mean, I'm controlling you, so technically I should believe in myself, but I really don't. I believe in you, so please, just take the controls somehow and play the game for yourself, because it's the only way you're going to survive. This is the only way you're going to get the clocks. You're never going to make it home or to the beach or whatever it is. If you don't take control for yourself, like, take control of your own life, Bugs. Don't expect players with controllers with incredibly wonky controls to do these things for you. And oh crap. Damn it, why can you not jump on him? Okay. Yeah. Oh, jeez. Find the carrot. Where is he? Oop. And there's a clock. Voice. And I'm a dive into his ass. Oop. Ow. Good work. And there was something here. Am I being crazy? I'm pretty sure I saw a shadow here, as if something was going to drop. I'm being crazy. It wouldn't be the first time. And... Alright, more box puzzles. That's the greatest thing in every game ever. And that's a crab. Crabs and boxes. The greatest of combinations. Seriously, how are you guys managing that? Does not seem physically possible. And, I mean, I know we're in a Looney Tune card, Looney Tune game, but still, it just... At least obey some laws, you know? It's just polite, really. I mean, can you imagine if people just stopped obeying laws of physics now? How old would it be like, dude, why are you floating off into space? Yeah, fuck gravity, but... I kind of want to fly now. I've made myself sad. God damn it, gravity. Literally the worst. And a box. That was me thinking that... Okay, two boxes. This movement speed. Come on, Bugs. Okay. Boop. God damn nose. God damn everything. And... Still not got a payoff for those acme boxes, but I'm assuming that we get like five or something. Like, five's usually the magic for those kind of things, right? If it's not free. No, three is for boss, for damaging bosses. Five is usually the breakables in a level. Right, that sounds good to me. Totally gonna go with that logic. Based on absolutely nothing, of course. You know, what I need to do there was go get that golden carrot, but did I? Oh no, already. Brain is literally non-existent. And a clock. Really need to make sure I enunciate that word right, otherwise you're collecting something very different in this game and it becomes very, very different as a genre. Rating definitely goes up a little. Okay, bye, I guess. Doesn't seem to tire out. There must be a button to... Nope, no button to kick the camera behind you. It's slightly annoying. Okay. There must be... Ah, there we go. Whoop! Hit it. Greatest ever. I know I keep saying that, but it's really just because I mean it. Like, I don't know if you guys have seen me play games, but I'm pretty damn amazing at them. That's... Every time I speak... I should just stop talking myself. In fact, I should start talking myself down. More likely to do me good. I just noticed you. And apparently we're doing it this way, that's fine. Damn it, bugs! Okay. Boop! That seems physically possible. Not gonna complain, though. Golden carrots, not bad. I think it's like 100 per... block? Like, I've literally seen nothing to suggest that, but I would guess that's the case. Add a push. Alright. Back over here. Back to where we were, but we're getting closer. Whoop. Oop. I need to stop jumping and just... He does a hop whenever he, oh, yep. Yeah. Bugs versus pirate. Bugs comes off lesser. Wait, I already kicked this, haven't I? Yeah. I don't actually need to do that again. Ooh! And we're this way. Oh, not these guys. Boop, and... Boop. There we go. Fixed it. Fixed everything. I should probably get that checkpoint rather than tempting fate. Boop. And we'll take this. Reasons. Like, I don't even know that I need it yet, I just want it. That kind of person. Like, literally, there's no reason for me to necessarily use this. Probably gonna despair, isn't it? Damn it! Box. I need you. Over here. You're mine now. Bugs? Okay, there we go. Oi! I can make it. And, oh, there we go. Carrot. Why not? I'm probably going to need that box, aren't I? Like, they usually give you the amount of boxes you need. But the fact that I didn't take that is going to bite me in the ass, but oh well. No reason to come up here? Yeah, literally no reason whatsoever. Cool. Oh, cool. Spare, nice one. I was fully expecting it to. Whee! You know, makes them the worst pearl necklaces ever, like pearls for jewelry ever. Like, I made this necklace out of it, and now it's disappeared. So, another freebie. Which I mean, another three pearls required! Okay, I don't know how I made it over there. Thank you, Mr. Clam. Stealing your. This is not a baby, because it's not like an egg or anything. What is a pearl? Is it just condensed sand? It's always what I've... I don't know why I think these things, but I just assumed it was like the sandal stuff that clam arrows from. I know nothing about clams. I don't... Or oysters. I'm not going to bother trying to assume what these things are, because it's just going to make me look like an idiot. Stick to the things I do know. For example, like jumping over barrels. And throwing pearls at targets. Stationary targets, preferably. It's not ever moving here. We've already seen that my skill levels are not great. We're over. Damn it. Let's go get the torch. I'm going the wrong way. Literally right near there. I'd be there now if I hadn't gone away. I'd at least be by the torch. I'll do these jumps quickly. Can I remember this stuff being so much harder when I was a kid? I just did not have the patience for it, I guess. Okay, I walked into the explosion after it happened? quickly. I was hoping that'd be a cutscene or something to make me seem more professional, but no. Game can't back me up like that. I'd require it to be bro-ish. And apparently the rabbit hole I went down has disappeared. I feel like I missed stuff. Boop! As a bone. I think if I... Not the direction you were... Bugs, just... I told you earlier to start playing yourself, but I think... thinking that that's actually a bad idea. Ooh. I think I'm... but... Damn it! I've got to get the bomb and throw it back to him. And that allows me to go on the pole, which is needed. Barrels. Boop. And you're dead. Alright, I'm remembering the game bit by bit. It's happening, I promise. I'm fairly certain that... if the shark is near me when I'm on those barrels, it will just eat me. Like, I'm pretty sure I remember that being a thing. You gonna go over there? No, that's too far away. Yep. And go get it. Gonna. Yeah, he is. Q. Apparently, they're the underwater dogs going after bones, I guess. Fetching bones. I guess that opens up. This is probably the end of the level, if I was to guess. Fortunately, the shark doesn't look at the turn quick. Pardon me. I really have all the bodily functions that a professional streamer needs. I'm toad professional. Really, just stop. Trying to make myself seem better. Anyway, whatsoever. Maybe I'll actually do well at video games. Go get that. Come on. Come on, Finny. Good boy. Okay, you can back to the barrels, please. Okay, we're safe. And now for you, Finny Jr. That was literally not... I don't know. That was the worst throw up of all time. Okay. The worst here. Okay, that should be good enough. Okay. Ooh. Okay, ouch! Okay, I was nowhere near that. Really? Hey. Worst thing is, the checkpoint's over here, so I'm actually further away than I was when I started the level. And I say that with this section of the level, so... Okay, Finny is occupied. Let's see if we can get Finny Jr. in the first throw. Come on. And there we go. It's actually a good throw. That should occupy him. Oh, no. Don't feel like sharks should be snapping out of the water. Like, I should stop trying to apply normal logic to the Looney Tunes game. Like, that's just not gonna happen, is it? Oh, God. Okay. Just took a half a carrot from me. I feel like shark stealing my carrot is a bit of an odd thing, but you know. At least he didn't eat Bunny. That would be disastrous. Quite literally, because I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm actually the Bunny. Oh. I mean, in game, I'm not actually a Bunny in real life. Like, I should probably, you know, mention that. I confirm any rumors now, or sorry, deny any rumors. I may in fact be a Bunny, not actually a Bunny. Come on, go away. Okay. They're very bouncy crabs. And... okay, so it's just... as long as I stay on the left, I should be fine. Oh, I see. I've got to... these controls are literally going to kill me. Over and over. Ah, must have done this bit so many times now. Okay, he's gone that way. Fine. Good, Finny. Now, Finny Jr., can you play just as nice? It'd be really nice if there was a checkpoint over here. Like, I feel like... Ooh. Okay. Alright, made it. These carrots are literally jumping about. Scared. Got a golden carrot. Made the life useful, I guess. I promise I won't be on this level for the rest of my life. I'm not promising you guys, I'm promising myself. I need to know it right now. That I'm not going to be on this level for the rest of my life. Cause it's starting to make me feel like I might actually be on this level for the rest of my life. Like, not even the level as a whole, just this bit of this level. And there you go. Boop. Okay. Finally! Okay, I've got another golden carrot to get here next to pirates as well, annoyingly. How about that? Oh, I've got another two golden carrots to get here, okay. Okay. These actually look like they're easier to get because they're higher up, so you don't have much risk of the pirate getting you. But I don't know how much the pirate can get you because I feel like he touched me. Inappropriately. When I got the first golden carrot, but it didn't actually seem to hurt me. Boop. Okay, yeah, you just go away. Boop, boop, boo. And my torch is done. Why are you not? There we go. Okay, he's trying to hit me now. Okay, two golden carrots. And... boop. I think that was all the dynamite in there. Looks like it. Okay. Where to next? Boop, boop. And boop. It's just a normal carrot. That said, withdraw. Okay, he's actually tired out of breath, which means that he can drop something. Or he has the chance of being killed, I should say. These are very unhealthy bad guys. Like, do a bit more cardio. Says me. Come on. And we got a wheel. Okay. Okay. Bugs, you gonna grab it? Bugs? Okay then. Let's go over here. Touch the checkpoint before I die. Whew, thank you. Let's see if there's something else we have to do before... that'll react to us. Oh, this is literally the way on. I feel like I'm just supposed to touch this and it's... Oh, hum. Ah, okay. Where there's a wheel, there's a way. What's this? Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. That looks like a fast travel between points. I'm okay with that. Okay. Now can I? Okay. Maybe there's more things I'm supposed to get. Like, let's try. Let's check to make sure there's nothing over this side. Like, there's got to be a reason that it has this over here. Oh.
Hello, travel hair. Let me save your position.
I'm not gonna lie and say. Hey, up, Gabe. I'm good, thanks. Hope you are. Just playing some old games from my prehistoric years. And absolutely stuck, which is embarrassing because I definitely did this as a kid. I know it's got something to do with this bloody wheel over here, but I can't touch anything with that. Game. Good to hear, mate. I mean, I'm getting steadily worse. I'm not gonna lie. Like, playing this bloody thing. Definitely missing something, but I can't figure out what. Either that or the ROM I've got is somewhat glitched. Which is also a possibility. Ho hum, I'll get there eventually. This is just. Certain you're supposed to just touch that and it's. Or I'm missing something or I'm. I hate this. Problem is, I can't even tell if this is like me missing something or if this is a glitch. Damn it. I feel like it should just go over to the. Like, it should just shoot over here and become a wheel, right? That just seems. There's a wheel, there's a wheel. Yeah, I know that. Have a look, see if there's anything over here I'm missing. I feel like you're supposed to be able to lead the shark somewhere as well. Why is that a thing? Yeah. Don't. Really hope it's not glitched, because I was actually looking forward to playing through this game. Just gonna do a quick wander around, make sure I've not missed anything. Because, you know, it wouldn't be completely out there if I were to slightly miss one or two important things in a game. And bother feeding the sharks there, like, just run it and see what happens. No, nothing. Does that mean you are glitched, game? Because I'd really like for you not to be glitched. I think it is just. It's just not working. Slightly annoying. Let's try. What happens if I do the level?
Hello, travel hair. Let me.
Thanks, Mile.
Bye.
Yeah. Bye, Mile.
That wouldn't be a bad idea. I will just quickly. Hopefully it keeps my collectibles, so I'll do a quick exit, restart the level, and see if getting back there fixes it. hopefully that'll make things easier. Google may very well be my second choice there. Should it not work? However, apparently I don't need to complete the game, or complete the level to unlock the next level.
Thanks, Mile.
Although, I wouldn't mind completing it if I can. Treasure Island, population 1. Yeah, we've seen this already. Come on. Doop-a-doop-a-doo. One thing I don't miss from old games is their loading times. And unskippable little things. Ah! Damn it, I've got to redo the Acme boxes. Annoying little box puzzles. Excuse me, sir. Thank you. If it is glitched this time around, I think I might just switch games to someone else. Got a few other things in mind that I wouldn't mind playing. It's just going to mean I'm not going to have any shiny thumbnails or anything for it. And you'll probably be having to put up with the little Bugs Bunny image there because I'm too lazy to sort out anything else. Gotcha. Doobity-bity. I'm literally the worst. All I need to do is get back to where I was. I'm not going to bother with the Acme puzzle either. I will just try and complete the level. And I'll consider that a victory. So, thank you. Stupid crabs. Come on. I'm at that point where my brain is just focused on nothing but getting to where I was as quick as possible. God damn it, game. There's probably something really obvious I'm missing as well. Okay. And I need a... No, I don't need a torch for this one. Thinking of another puzzle later on. Just kind of went for the torch and walked off the edge there. I'd have played this game, played this level so much. Tempted to switch game just to get out of this bloody level. Yep. Grabs of boomerangs. Still a thing for some reason. Oop. This is giving me the craving to go back and watch some old Looney Tunes cartoons, so. Or even the new one, like. The new one is actually not bad. At least when I watched it a couple of years ago, it didn't seem too bad. Like, it's not the same format as the old ones, where like could be any time, any genre. The old ones are like basically little short stories. The new series is just weird. It's like a Odd Couple thing with Daffy and Bugs sharing a house. It's actually quite funny. I enjoyed it. Okay. Gone. That was good timing. Not on purpose. I'm not gonna pretend that I timed it, but it ended up being good timing. Whatever the weather. And... Dip. Thank you, guys. So kind of you. Checkpoint. And I need the pearls. God damn it. Just Just get rid of you so you're not going to be an issue. And we'll start on our long quest for pearls and target hitting. You know when you've been playing a level too long when the soundtrack is starting to drill itself into your brain. Boop. 2 out of 3. Ain't bad, as Meatloaf once said. That's not too bad, that puts me on the platform. And... Did that count? I need to know, otherwise I need a pearl. Game? Did that... Alright, I just need to get close. Very polite of the barrel to wait for me. Like, oh, I see you slipped and fell there like an idiot. I guess I'll wait for you before I, show myself resurfacing. Also, very weird contraption that hitting certain targets makes barrels float. Like, just strange design on the pirate's behalf. Okay, got it. I'm not gonna make it. Damn! Oh, I made it. Just, like... That explosion gets me every time. What's my favourite game to play? It completely depends on what mood I'm in, really. Like, there's a lot of old games I'd love that, if I'm feeling nostalgic, same with old cartoons and stuff. Sometimes I'm feeling stressed and stuff, I love going back to the old stuff, like Super Mario World, Digimon World is one of my all-time favorites, and Final Fantasy 7 through 9, with an emphasis on 8, really. But in general, if I'm just playing things, Gears of War 3 Horde mode is one of my favorite things, although I've not played that in a while, actually. Payday 2, absolutely love the stealth in that game. I think it's one of the best stealth systems ever, and is hugely satisfying, so absolutely love playing that, if I wanted to feel good about myself. I know this isn't really... this is more of a list than a single favourite game, but I really am just that kind of person where it completely depends on the mood I'm in. All-time favourite game. Like, not necessarily to play, but just all-time favourite game is probably Halo Combat Evolved. Like, I've got so many good memories of that game. Used to play it all the time with my dad. Me and my friends used to get together and play big... Big LAN parties of that. With, like, 8-player multiplayer on it. And it was amazingly fun. You got any favourites, Gabe? Yeah. Ooh, made it. See if I can beat you and get the wheel to appear without glitching. Assuming it was glitched and I'm not just being an idiot. Which is an entire possibility, I understand. Sir, there we go. Ow. Okay, you got your revenge. Let's try and keep it up here. Maybe it was because it landed on a specific angle or something down there. Like, what's the chances of it landing in a very specific place to glitch out? Okay, no, still not. And you're supposed to bloody pick it up with the... I told you I'd be missing something stupid. Like, absolutely moronic. My god. I never struggled with games like this as a kid, but... Like, obvious things like that I just miss, apparently, nowadays. Oy. There's the right trigger to shoot. That's the kind of game I play nowadays. Boop. Alright. So, you just came down? Yeah. Let's see what's on here then. Boop. Unfortunately, at some point I will be going back through this level. I don't think that'll be... If I end up streaming this over multiple sessions, this will be in a later, a different stream, as I don't fancy doing this level again right now. That's a good choice. I've never actually played Rocket League. I've heard so many good things about it. Like, and I do actually own it. One night I actually bought it on impulse because some friends were playing it. And then I just didn't feel like playing, unfortunately. So, and I've not gone back to it. So I've literally, I bought it and I've never opened it, annoyingly. That's the kind of idiot I'm in money sometimes. Paladins is a lot of fun. Like, been playing that a lot with yourself, Laurie, and Bezek, recently. And it is just a very fun game. Not usually my kind of thing. Like, I'm not much into, like, competitive games, typically. I much prefer my PvE to my PvP. But, oh, I will admit, oh my, wow. I think there's a couple of games out there that I have a lot, like, Gmod is probably the one that I have the most hours on. Like, 470 hours is pretty damn amazing. Like, I'm trying to think. I must have several hundred in Gmod. Like, I'm not sure. I couldn't guess at even close to an exact figure, but that's the one that I've put the most hours into, I'd say. Just because we tend to have a Sunday night gaming session, me and a load of friends, and quite often, at least it used to be, that was Gmod, because, you know, Gmod is just fun, and usually has us in tears of laughter. We're actually playing another game, Unfortunate Spaceman, the other day, and it was actually kind of fun. It's like a space version of Troubling Terrorist Town. Have you tried that? I have not, but just the PvE on that on Paladins in general is not. I don't want to say the phrase "not fun," but it can very much be not fun. Like, I've tried the KFC one where you have flamethrower guy and the guy who turns people into chickens. Tried the other one, was it Frog Hopper or something? Where the guys were just basically jumping around and trying to Goomba stomp us. And they were just so ridiculously difficult. Like, oh my god. Who is it who's actually in the, what is the new hide and seek one? I'm gonna guess it's either the new one, what's her face? What's her face? The one that summons darkness as a special. And is it Nyx? The one that has a smoke bomb and the ability to go invisible? I would guess it's them. Like, just from the name. Damn it. Needs to jump one higher. Doop, 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 doop. Needs to jump one higher, so I'll bring two crates with me. Because. Damn it! And this'll do me. Pardon me. And we're up. Not going for the acme crates, as I say. We've already missed a load of those, unfortunately. I will, however, grab the clock. Oh! Oh, no, I hadn't actually seen that as a thing. Scarbius was actually talking about the, he was talking about the new patch earlier. I'll fully admit, it was one of those situations of my eyes had kind of glazed over and I wasn't fully listening because, well, there's only so much Scarbius talk I can take, you know, before falling asleep. And hopefully he's not watching, otherwise he may actually, you know, kill me. But, I've not been on Paladins since before the patch, so I didn't actually know that was a thing. That'd be kind of cool and interesting to try. How am I supposed to get up here? What am I doing wrong, game? Game, tell me. Pretty sure this was just hiding, so yeah, it was hide the chest. I have kicked this, haven't I? Nope, I have not. So I was missing that, just generally. Can I? There's no. Maybe you can jump that? Doesn't look like a jumpable gap. Damn it, game. Damn it, game. Okay, screw that. Coming back to the level later, anyhow, we'll grab it at that time. Hopefully, we're actually near the end of this level now because this song is actually driving me insane. Yay, boss time. Assume this is boss. Tell you what game I did get earlier today, actually, Gabe, was Rainbow Six Siege. Actually, a very fun game. Very strategic first-person shooter. Gotcha! And your second hit. It's very nice, this guy, to deliver things for me to... Okay. Come on! Bugs! I mean... I'm putting in the right direction. You can at least... There we go. Oh! Okay. She didn't realise that he had three hits. That's kind of a cool concept. So that's actually a... Ooh, thank you. You stopped me from picking up a explodey one. That's a cool concept. Is that permanent then, Gabe? Wee. Like, is that actually going to be on the, is that base going to be available permanently then? Like, that's quite an interesting idea, I'll admit. Finally, please tell me this, no, this isn't the end because it's not got the blue sparkles, has it? Doop-a-doop-a-doo. Okay, boss time. This is a big level. Looking around to make sure there's nothing over here. There is not. What you said, mutant bearing? Like, I'm not carrying any mutants on me. Okay, maybe I'm supposed to throw it from there. Huh. That's kind of cool. I'll be, we'll have to give it a try next time we're playing. Doop, 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 doop. Okay, I want you to throw it. Throw me some dynamite, Yosemite. Come on. Is he still Yosemite when he's not a cowboy? Oop. Present. Okay. Ouch. Ouch. Yeah, I think that was... I feel like that was available last time we played. It was just, I remember talking to Scarby Simpsetra about it. But I can't remember what they were talking about. Again, I wasn't paying full attention. Oop. I'm a very good friend and a great listener, as you can tell. And another present. Oh, it's just going to second hit, and I can see his health bar. Looks like it's going to be a 5-hit boss. Oh, come on, no. I needed that row of boxes. Okay, it's very fortunate these things refloat. Refloat? Resurface, that's the word I'm looking for. Doop-a-doop-a-doo. Happy Christmas! Okay, and he killed me. Wasn't paying full attention. Ooh. Christ. I'll have to give him a go next time we're on. And you're over here. Okay. It's very fortunate you seem to have unlimited lives in this game. I don't remember that being a thing, but I'm not going to complain. Kind of useful for when you're as shit as I am. And we're okay. That cannot jump that gap. Oh my god. Okay. This is the last thing. It's very fortunate that he turns his back on us as well. Like, you know, Very clever guy, is Yosemite. Finally done with the level. Oh my god, is it real? Is it true? God, yeah, clock. Okay, I get it, we've got a clock. More important thing. Oh, level ends. Oh my god.
Good, but you left some stuff behind you. Let me save your position.
Sure.
Thanks, Moyle.
Bye.
Goodbye, Moyle.
Goodbye, Moyle. All right. I think there was one open up in here as well, but I'm not sure how it. How we actually get in there. Feel like it's a ability we don't have yet. Say? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is. So what we'll do is head to the next world, I guess. Or next time period, more specifically. 1930s. And go for the big bank heist. Ah, okay. So 99 carats gets us a golden carat in each world, I'm pretty sure. Okay then. Big bank withdrawal, I guess.
Let's get out of here, Mugsy.
Okay, boss.
I mean, Bugs, the greatest of Ace is going after him, I guess. This sounds like there's a dog down there. Okay. I was very confused there for a minute. Boop. Oh, really? Boop. Boop. Ah! No! Stay away from me! Gee, mutt. Boop! Oh. Boop! Dog! Definitely a dog there. And. Boop. Okay, that's an easy enough pattern. Don't worry, dog. I can manage without giving you a bone. Boop. Ouch! Boop! And. Oh, okay. Oh, fortunately, you don't seem to want to go in the little safety deposit areas. I'm not going to complain, it makes my life easier. Hey, Mugsy! Why do you care about the rabbit? Like, I feel this is not necessary for you to go after the rabbit. Ooh, carrot. And another one. Boop!
Hey, Mugsy, wake up.
And you're throwing bombs at me for some reason. Where do we go from here? Door locked, you need a key, bunny. Okay, the fact that those bombs are not blowing up straight away makes me feel to use them for something. So next one that drops, we will throw at him maybe? Nope. There we go. Let's go in here, see what we get. Boo. Almost got 99 carats as well. It's nice. Excuse me, sir, can I get a bomb? Thank you. Very nice of him, like, he's very helpful, is that man, whatever his name is. It's the clock. Oh, there I am. Excuse all the nose scritching and sniffing. What? Two. The only way I can go is up, right? Let's see. Okay. She kind of confused there, I'm not gonna lie. Heading up there, I'm not gonna be able to make it up there, am I? Even with multiple boxes, no, I'm not gonna go up there, so I don't know what I'm getting at. Key. Oh, okay, I get it. I see what I'm doing. It only took me long enough. Boop! Skip box by using that jump. And doors open. Fixed it. Doors unlocked. Why can't I out? There we go. And he left a bomb for me. Oh, nice. He knew. Oh, God! Sir, that is extremely rude. You are not a potted plant. Please stop pretending to be. There we go. That was something I had considered. Ah! Helmet. It was making me think that I need to use the bombs for something to advance. Ah! Okay. And speaking of big green door, there we go. Whew. Seriously, going back to these old, like, I don't want to call it a puzzle game, because it's not really, but these old adventure games that I was able to do without issues as a kid just makes me feel so dumb. Greatest safe ever. Literally the best. Ouch! I feel like this guy is... I remember this being something. There's a golden carrot on the door, so... Fairly sure. Okay, I think actually if I let him... If I let him get out, he'll run somewhere. Oh? Is this something I can throw at him? That would explain it. Boop, boop, boop. Sir, I've got something for you. There we go. Nope, never mind. I'm literally the worst. Urgh. Door into here. Can probably get rid of that by throwing you at it. Yes. Boop. Is that close enough or is that ass too far? Yeah. Okay. That should get you. Ooh. These people keep very weird things in their vaults. And a clock. Okay, so where next? Hoi, hoi, hoi. Yes, bugs. Very good at kicking air. Okay, so he's... I don't... I wonder if I'm supposed to wait for him to get out and then... That's it? Okay, I need to get a key to get out of that. So, to figure out how to hit these guys in the doors... Okay, so it's just literally, that's simple enough. Don't need them to come out, you can just... I need more dynamite for this one. Doop, doop, doop. One. I think there's some in here. Doop, doop, doop. Should have known, if in doubt, throw bombs at it. That's usually the way to fix most things. And kablooey. Very fortunate they're standing right by the doors so as to get hit by the explosions. Good. Hey sir, why are you shooting at a bunny rabbit? Like, literally, a rabbit walks into a bank, you don't just open fire on it. Like, maybe, actually, now I think about it, a humanoid bunny rabbit carrying TNT, I'd probably shoot. Well, I wasn't carrying TNT, so. Sir? not sure what happened there. Ugh, another one? You got, ow. Boop! Pro play there, pro play. Dope's amazing. Okay, so all the doors been blown off the hinges. I think the keys I'm missing. Any other idea I could think of? Get some more TNT. Maybe try throwing it at the big double doors that wouldn't open? Oh no, the reason they won't open is because of this. Probably as much the bookshelves in the way. Anything else? Yep. So key? Anywhere? Key. Anybody got a key? It's a singular key. It's in one of the safes. Would be my guess. Hey. Destroyed. Seriously. Okay, in here. Okay, this free look is terrible. It's very limited. Hang on a second. Okay, so there must be some reason to bookshelf, like, or to open the main door. Like, that's not a big enough shortcut on its own. Justify it, surely? Maybe it's just to show you that you can. There we go. Figure it out. Yeah? Thank you. I need to go fetch some dynamite. I have a problem. Dynamite can fix it. That is just a life lesson in general. Come on, Bugs. You can do it. I believe in you. There we go. And home Dylan as well. Quite a nice little dynamite. Oh, finally. Whew. This way. That was correct. Right, let's see if we can go find boss. And I've got enough carrots for... Boop! That's nice. And... Go on there, apparently. Whoa! Made it. Need this, for reasons. Thank you! You have a very strange... Why are you keeping a clock? Seems odd. Okay, I'm gonna need to sneak him once he settles down for a nap. I do really like the Blood Bowl games. Like, I think there's a video on our channels for me and Scarbius of us playing a match of that. I love it, but my luck in it is terrible. Like, it's well worth checking those videos out just to see, like, if you've ever been unsure how much a person can be screwed by luck. Like, just watch that video. Like, It's both of us have our own perspective, so you can check out on either channel. But it is, my god, I roll badly on everything. So I'm gonna need you to settle down so I can. Thank you. Sir, I need your key. I just want your key. All I want to do is break in this bank and steal the key from it that's floating above your head. Like, you're not even using it. I'm not even sure you know it's there. Are you gonna settle down to sleep? Okay, I accidentally got too close to that. Yeah, okay, I know where I'm not wanted. Fortunately, you don't seem to care if I'm standing in. I'll admit, it's one of the board games I actually want to get hold of, although I'm not sure, because do you have to buy all the different teams separately? Like, I feel it'd be a very costly investment, but I have Blood Bowl 1 and 2, both on Steam. Fortunately, he hasn't seemed to notice me. But yeah, I have Blood Bowl 1 and 2 on Steam, and they are brilliant. At one point, myself, Scarbius, and Bezek were thinking of starting a little YouTube-y tournament with it. This was probably a couple of years ago, however. So I don't feel like that is still a thing. But yes, it is a very fun game, and dwarves all the way. See, that's why I couldn't get the board game then. Like, has to have dwarves. Like, dwarves for the win. If you're not starting the game with a bulldozer, you're not starting the game properly. Great. Thank you. That's a nice key. Just to make things fun. There's a hammer here. What's this supposed to be for? Is this supposed to be for hitting you? I don't know. I just wanted to try and do things with the hammer. Leave me alone! Ah! I will accept that friend request in a little while when I'm on this game. Don't think I've ever actually seen the Mummies team. Is that... were they out on release of Blood Bowl 2? They've been added since. Because I don't... Like, I knew there was an undead team, but I didn't... Actually, saying that, I'm not even sure I knew there was an undead team. Now I think about it out loud. They have always been... they are a cool kind of concept for thing. I liked the chaos as well. Like, basically, I just liked any hard-hitting team. Any team that's tactic is kill the enemy team as opposed to get the ball to the front of the field. Like, I just enjoyed that kind of gameplay for it, because it just worked so well. Oh! Ah! It's just me. These people have against bunny rabbits, anyhow. I've realised that you don't need to actually have both words when describing a bunny rabbit, but I just feel like you do have to, like, despite what I just said. Ah, okay. I get you. Wait. Again, I didn't even fully know there was a... Oh. There you go. I didn't even know there was a dead team in general. Okay. Boop. Alright, chat to you later then, Gabe. Let's say I'll... Hopefully we'll get to play some Paladins again soon. I can't even figure out where that bloody thing was. Whoop! And up we go. Figured it out, fixed everything. Big bad girl. Ooh! Please don't grab the rabbit. Not nice, not appreciated. I suddenly realised how I would have got that key downstairs. Ow. 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 Did it do anything? Thank you. Oh, I need that. Okay. I feel like I've found a safe place. This is my hiding place. Mugsy, oh Mugsy. Okay, he can't see me. What do you have against rabbits? All I was doing was exploring this building. Looting the safes for everything they're worth, but that kind of feels like that's what you guys were doing anyhow, so... What really does have... What do you have against that? Kind of hypocritical, if you ask me. Come on. Boop. Okay, this is actually much easier than both of the boss fights so far. Oh, look at the time it took me to get through this level as opposed to get through the pirate level. Ow. 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 I messed up. Oh god, I messed up. Ouch. Oh, okay, now I need to get to near Mugsy without taking a single hit. Mugsy! Hey, get over here. And final hit on the boss is coming up. That was Mugsy I just kicked there. Boop. Okay, finally. I reckon I've got one more level in me for the rest of the stream. Behind you. Yeah, I know. Save your position. Looking forward to the to when I have to just go back through all these levels trying to figure out where everything is. Goodbye, Moyle. There is legitimately reason that you may not be able to get everything at once, however, there are abilities you do unlock as you go. Feel like... Oh god, I don't think I have enough for another level. Okay, so I've not got enough for another level in this world. Art years. Stone Age. Quick look here, see if there's anything new. No, it's just the two that I've already done. Where? 66 and 23. Already 19% for the game, apparently. Oy. After only, what, four levels? Three levels and a boss that was oddly separate to the level as opposed to all the ones. It's parrot ears. Right. I'm 7 off unlocking that level, or that world, so I kind of get that's probably not a... what I'm supposed to do. The fact that there is a level that opened up in here makes me think that I can actually get in here. Like, that's... you'd think that's a thing, right? I'm just being crazy. I mean, I could be being crazy. I usually am pretty damn crazy. F35. Boo. Don't tell me I actually have to go... back in a level. 7 out of 9 and 17 out of 17. Okay, I'm only missing two there. I can't feel like they're that anal about it. Let's see. Feel like... did I miss something opening up? Am I being an idiot or... 6 out of 6 clocks, 12 out of 15 golden carats. Like, I've missed like 3 clocks total. Should be another level open. 50. 2. I'm missing something there, right? Levels there are. Oh wow. So it's 30, 40, and 120. How many did I miss in the prehistoric world? Like, haven't missed... 1 out of 1, 5 out of 5. Okay. And so I've missed a total of 3 clocks. There's no way I could get any of the 30s that are around. It has to be the level on the Pirate Island that I'm not getting into. Something there missing. God damn it. I wanted one simple level. Bark on it for a night. But we get in. Huh? Like a level that has 24, maybe? Like, damn it! Alright, I think what's probably the best method is if I end things here, and then before the next stream, I will have a look around, see if I can figure out where I'm missing either a clock. Well, not where I missed a clock, where I'm missing a level. Or... I have to go back into a level and find some of the missing clocks. God, I don't have to go through the pirate level again. Oh well. If I do, I do. Be good to get out of the way, I guess. There's only 2 clocks I'm missing, and I think I know exactly where they are. Anyway, hope folks enjoyed. I'm going to be trying to stream a little more often nowadays, because it is fun. And I do have the time for it. So I should do. But so, keep your eye out for that, and I will catch you next time. Bye bye now.